I'm simply questioning the credibility of the accused, Your Worship. You may recall she went to great pains telling us of her dedicated work in getting youngsters away from the drug scene. Unfortunately, her record indicates that she was convicted of drug trafficking herself.
You can't say that. You can't mention Judy's record and here you're prejudicing the court.
If you don't mind, Mrs. Morris, I'm conducting these proceedings. Strike the reference to the accused record. Continue and restrict yourself to matters currently before the court.
Yes, Your Worship. On the afternoon of the 9th, which is the day in question, what was your purpose in going to Driscoll House?
I promised Miss Bryant I'd call in and see how things were progressing.
So one would imagine that she'd be eager to show you around?
I suppose so.
Yes, and did she? Or did she steer clear from certain sections of the building?
She didn't attempt to hide anything, if that's what you mean.
Well, what was her reaction when you first saw Gaffney stealing your car?
Well, I can't really say. My attention was taken up with what was happening in the street below.
Mrs. Morris, in your opinion, did Bryant know of Margot Gaffney's presence at the halfway house? Well?
I wasn't aware that I could be asked to pass an opinion.
Restrict yourself to direct questions, Mr. Hastings.
Yes, Your Worship. Mrs. Morris, did Bryant give any indication that she knew of Gaffney's presence?
My answer could jeopardize the future of Driscoll House, which, in my opinion, is one of the finest projects the department has ever been involved in. I am not prepared to answer that question.
There's been enough time wasted already this morning. In future, I'd advise prosecuting counsel not to waste the court's time with hostile witnesses. Mrs. Morris, you will answer the question or be charged with contempt of court. I'm quite sure you won't want to return to Wentworth Detention Centre as an inmate.
Well, Mrs. Morris?
Lizzie, the parole board's waiting for you.
Oh, hang on.
What on earth are you doing?
What do you reckon? Do I look as though I've got a fever?
No, get out of here.
Ah, Mrs. Burnsworth. Sit down, would you? And now we won't keep you waiting. This must be quite a strain on you.
No, I'm all right.
Well, Dr. Marsden has written quite a comprehensive report for us, and you'll be pleased to hear that we wholeheartedly agree with his recommendations.
Bloody! Oh, that's nice. What's that mean?
Yes, Mrs. Burnsworth, you'll be given your parole license.
Congratulations, Lizzie.
Thank you, Mrs. Davidson. I wonder if Dr. Marsden does house calls. I'd still like him to look after me when I'm in the halfway house.
That won't be necessary, Mrs. Burnsworth.
Oh, I think so. He knows me history. Anyway, I wouldn't like anyone else to look after me.
No, you don't understand. You see, according to Dr. Marsden's report, you're going to need quite a lot of care. And we're worried that you won't get that care at the halfway house.
Of course I will. Jude's my mate. She'll look after me.
Nevertheless, we feel it necessary to place a proviso on the license. It's only for your own good.
Proviso? What is it?
That your parole be suspended until we can find a suitable place for you. Of course, there are dozens of old people's homes about, but we must find one that has the proper medical attention available.
Old people's home?
Yes, Mrs. Burnsworth. A place where you can relax and mix with people of your own age. Don't worry. You'll be well looked after.
Oh, hello. What's going on then? Oh, looks like someone's in for it.
No, just some of my customers come to visit. Probably still want their cut.
Hang on. Looks like they're bringing someone in. Oh, must be a real toff to get all that attention. That bitch Morris. Trust her to get a ride to work with the cops. Why they got her by the arms? Maybe she's sick. Almost looks like they're bringing her in under arrest, don't it?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. Around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the storm. The roses here are prisoners too, when morning comes around.